Have you ever seen this image? Nefertiti is well known by almost every child, but this is the most unique image of the world. Anyone can see it at close range. Pope Benedict XVI remained a long time in front of it during his visit in Manoppello, Italy, on September 1, 2006. There you can find it at the high altar of the monastic church. What makes this image so unique? It is transparent and visible from both sides, and it seems to be mirror imaged. The face disappears in backlight. Only were you to put a hand behind it, it will become visible again. The image is not on a linen. It's on a silken veil made from the fine hairs of a mollusk shell, one of the most precious fabrics of the ancient world, upon which it is not possible to paint. Research has shown that no color pigments are on the veil, as you can see in this close-up. No one is able to explain today how this face came to be on the veil. It was found in the city walls of Edessa in the year 525. Since this time, it was used as the archetype for paintings of Christ. One of the oldest is the icon of Christ in the Vatican. From the beginning, this veil was named as acheropita, not made by human hands. It was brought to Constantinople in the year 574. Before the iconoclastic controversy started, the veil was brought to Rome by an unknown route in the year 700, where it was kept in the private chapel of the Pope at the Lateran Basilica. In medieval times, the veil was venerated as the most precious relic in the old St. Peter's Basilica. During the rebuilding of St. Peter's, one of the four massive pillars which support the dome was designed to store this amazing image, but the veil was never placed there. Where did this image come from? All historical evidence points to Jerusalem. New research shows that this image of the face is congruent in geometry with the face of the Shroud of Turin. See for yourself. Is the Volto Santo of Manoppello the veil which Peter and John found on Easter morning, together with the shroud in the empty tomb, as reported by the evangelist John? See John 20, 5 and following. Everything is pointing to it. If so, Jesus himself would have given us, in a mysterious way, the authentic image of himself during his resurrection. The painter M. Grunewald was apparently convinced of it and painted the face of the risen Christ according to this archetype. For this reason, the Volto Santo of Manoppello and the Shroud of Turin are the oldest manifest testimonies of his death and resurrection.